appreciate you so much tonight for worshiping with us.
Oh.
And my mind was taken back. I don't think the last time we were here, it must have been right after that. My sister Angie, did you ever meet Angie and Nella, my two single sisters that were, that traveled the same full time in the ministry? Angie, my oldest sister that had never been married, being one of them. We were three old maids before Brother Bobby came and stole me away and took me to Texarkana and married me. And my sisters always teased him and said that we prayed 7 years, a long time, for a piano player, and they forgot to ask the Lord to lead him in the group. And so he carted me off to Arkansas. They lived in Dallas-Fort Worth area, and my oldest sister, Angie, she almost raised me and my younger siblings. There are 7 children, and she was the oldest daughter, the oldest girl. And she come up sick, and we had 5 wonderful weeks with Angie when we found out she had gallbladder cancer. And when she did, and we all, because she had never been to the doctor before, they'd always trusted God with her healing. She had to go one time for insurance purposes with her job. But since they had been full time, she had not been to the doctor. And so she had suffered with gallbladder trouble off and on for years. And at one point, she felt like the Lord had just taken care of it, and he did. Well, by the time we found out about her being sick, and they got her to the doctor, and we couldn't quite get her healed, we found out that she had gallbladder cancer, and it had already spread to the liver. Well, we went out on Labor Day 2 years ago. Well, it'll be 3 years ago now. We went out Labor Day, and that was fun. We went out that weekend, and we left on Monday, and we came back on that following Friday. And I would not have believed it that I had not seen it, sis. She had gone from being up and walking until she was bedfast. And they had already moved her bed. They came in and put her bed in the bedroom. And hospice is wonderful if you've ever worked with hospice, and anybody that ever had to go through that. But whenever she was laying there, she didn't say anything for 2 or 3 days, you know. And on Tuesday morning, we knew it was going to be just any time. On Tuesday morning, her eyes flew open, and she saw Jesus come to get her, and she recognized him. And as he came closer, she started saying, "Jesus, Jesus." And of course, my daddy's been gone since 2004, and she said, "Daddy." She shut her eyes and was gone. Well, us being Holy Ghost filled and Spirit filled, we had a shout. While her feet struck the streets of gold, we shouted right along with her.
Amen.
Amen.
I can't say it's been easy. It's been one of the hardest things that has ever happened. But what I want to make known to you tonight is heaven is a real place. Yes.
Amen.
It's not always going to be forever and ever off in the distance. Someday it's going to be reality for you and I.
Amen.
Amen.
And it's important that we know it when he comes to get us.
Thank you, ma'am. That's right.
It reminds me of the time that Mary and Joseph took Jesus as an infant to the temple. Remember that story? It's a true story. Mary took Jesus into the temple to be dedicated, as was the custom. And when they walked in, and that old man Simeon saw that baby Jesus, he said, "Now, Lord, you can just take me on the boat." He saw the salvation of Israel. His prayer had been answered. And he recognized him. And Anna came in. She recognized him. And as a 12-year-old girl one day, I knelt at an old-fashioned altar, no carpet on the floor. But I realized that I needed a Savior. Amen. And when he came in, I recognized him.
Hallelujah.
And he's been my friend, my Savior, my Redeemer,
Amen.
I want you to listen to a song that we sing. It says, I've been to heaven, but I've never left the road. For you allowing us to come again. And but a year ago in February, we went in and so we recorded. We actually videoed it and recorded it. We do not have videos. That has never come through. Our little videographer has never given us our video. I wish I'd pray about that. We're going to be anti-cues by the time we get them. But anyway, we do have the recording with us tonight. And on that recording, it's some funny things. It's just us. It's just us. But I tell you what. Before we went into that concert, there was a lady came to my office. She was so excited about that first grandbaby, sis. And it was almost due. And she had a picture of it on her telephone. She wanted to show it to me. She had it all hugged up to her like this. And when she turned it around and showed it to me, Sister Bird, I went, because it was so detailed. You know, sonograms nowadays, because of the technology, it looked like that baby, she was holding it, but it was still in the womb. Man. And I've never seen anything like it. I'm just country. And you know, when I was pregnant 22 years ago, it didn't look like that. It just, you know, just didn't look like that. And when I saw that picture of that baby, had his eyes shut, and it went, and I'm telling you, just as soon as I did that, the Spirit of the Lord spoke to me and said, I give life.
Amen.
And the more I thought about that, I thought, Lord, you do give life. He gives life so abundantly, sometimes we can't stand it. We have to just pray, plumb through over it. And then those other times, life is so abundant. So abundant that he gave his only son that you and I might have life eternal. And he looked way beyond time and he saw that I needed a Savior. He saw you were going to need a Savior. And the hundreds and thousands people that have come to God. Some have answered, some have not. If you're here tonight and you've never answered, or if you've answered and you're running, this service is for you tonight.
Amen.
There's no time like the present. And today is the day of salvation. We're going to give you life and more abundant. Kiddos, you may be under 12 years old. You may be under 15. You may be under 5. It doesn't matter to Jesus. He died for you. He died for the oldest one of us and the youngest one of us. You may be on any far faults.
Shall always be my
And like Brother Bobby's doing a fine job. I want y'all to listen as he's saying, God, in a million years, you get behind him. This is our last song, unless y'all just insist. We're ready to go, too. I know y'all's probably hungry as we are. We went down here to get acquainted. We're just so at home. Y'all can tell that. I feel like I'm in your living room visiting with you. I'm always tell all kinds of funny things if I stick around. We better say, yeah, we'll talk this afterwards. Not many years.
We're coming to our attention.